The midlife crisis is a common phrase, but let's talk now about a troubling new trend, a millennial life crisis. Many 30-somethings say it sucks to have been born in 1990.
Now, they may well be blessed with technology, good health and career opportunities their parents dreamed of, but millennial life isn't all smashed avo and adventure travel. Apparently, social researcher Mark McCrindle has crunched decades of data on the generational divide, and he joins us now. Morning to you, Mark. OK, so, full disclosure, you're neither a boomer or a millennial.
That's right.
You're like me.
Sitting in the middle there, yes.
We're the X.
Between them, that's right.
Yeah. Okay.
I creep in. 1982. That's stunning
to
me.
Are you still X?
That I'm a millennial.
Oh, you're a millennial?
Yeah. Unbelievable to me.
That's right.
Yeah, just 90. Yeah,
can you? Caught in the body of a.
Of an 80-year-old man. Sorry, Mark. So, yeah, tell us, what's this kind of dilemma? What is the millennial life crisis?
Well, I guess they look at sort of the opportunities they've been given in life and wonder if they've fallen behind where their parents were at the same age. And maybe financially they are, but, you know, they've got a lot of benefits. I mean, health-wise, things have never been better. Smoking rates are the lowest ever. The survivability rates of diseases and illnesses, cancer, has never been better. And so life expectancy is at an all-time high. So this generation of young people will live around 5 years longer than their parents did. And then you add to that the education that they have access to. They're twice as likely to have a university degree as their parents. Their parents, about 20% had a degree. Today it's edging closer to 40%. So great opportunities there. But on the cost side, things aren't as good.
Look, lots of millennials just really feeling like they just can't afford to buy a house, that they just can't, you know, what's the sort of point of it all? When we're talking about which generation has it easier, it's very subjective, isn't it? How do you measure that?
Well, that's right. It depends on what you're looking for in life. If it's just financial, then certainly the millennials are having some challenges. But they're fitting more things in as well. You know, by their 20s, their parents had married, on average, had started a family and had bought their first home. For millennials, none of those occurrences are taking place, even if at all, until their 30s. So they're certainly pushing these life stages back.
It kind of comes down in many ways to happiness too, and however you define that, because, you know, millennials, they've got generations behind them, have better technology and travel options, but, you know, they have a lot to be happy about.
Well, they do. And, you know, the education, the ability to travel, the opportunity to connect. I mean, you know, living in the 21st century, the global opportunities they have is amazing. And yet, from a loneliness measure, about 40% of baby boomers say they experience periodic loneliness. For Generation Y or millennials, it's 70%. So much more likely to say they feel lonely and disconnected. Mm. The number one condition, health condition for millennials is mental health conditions. Mm. So health might be better in a physical sense, but uncertainty and anxiety is high.
Yeah, okay. So which is the best era for somebody to be in their early 30s?
Well, I think it's really a mix, isn't it? I mean, certainly it's a lot harder to buy a home and the cost of living is greater. The baby boomers will say, look, interest rates were higher in our time. And certainly millennials are earning more than their parents were, about 4 to 5 times as much. Their parents started their first job at about $15,000 a year, but they were buying their first home at about $70,000 a year. So the cost of housing is about 10 to 12 times today what their parents paid. So I guess earnings to cost of housing, it's tougher for young people, but they've got a lot of benefits as well. They've invested in education and more career opportunities.
Gosh, we've got to look beneath the stats, don't you, to actually be able to draw anything out of this.
One of the all-time great data crunchers.
He is.
Mark McCrindle.
Mark McCrindle.
Isn't he?
Absolutely.
Can and will crunch data.
Yes.
Thank you, Mark.
Thank you, Mark.
Thanks, Matt.
And decipher it for us. We really appreciate it.